It was a hot afternoon. Sammy, the elephant, was very thirsty. He came by a lake full of water. He stepped in, splashing about in the cool water. Little did he know that a crocodile was watching him at that very moment. The crocodile was a friendly fellow called Lallu. He never had an elephant for a friend before. He swam silently up to Sammy and pulled at his leg playfully. Sammy screamed in fear.
Why is this fellow screaming?
Wondered Lallu as he pulled Sammy into the lake. Mac, the monkey, was sitting on top of a mango tree. He was watching Lallu and Sammy. Mac knew Lallu meant no harm. He decided to distract Lallu.
Hey, Lallu!
Called out Mac. Do you want a mango? Lallu nodded his head in glee. Mac plucked a juicy mango from the tree and threw it down. Lallu left Sammy and caught the mango between his teeth. As Sammy ran in fear, Lallu took a bite of the mango.
Can you give me one more fruit? I would like to take it home to my wife.
Lallu's wife ate the mango with relish.
I'll get more for you tomorrow,
said Lallu.
That tree is full of mangoes.
Your friend must be eating those juicy mangoes all day,
said his wife.
I wonder how juicy his heart must be.
She said, licking her lips.
But he's my friend. Why can't we just eat mangoes instead?
Objected Lallu. Lallu's wife was irritated.
Sometimes you forget that you're a crocodile. Just get me the monkey's heart tomorrow.
Lallu meekly agreed to get what she asked for. The next day, he swam up to the mango tree. Mac, the monkey, was sitting on a branch eating a mango. He smiled when he saw Lallu. Did your wife like the fruit?
Ah, yes. In fact, she has invited you home for lunch today.
Mac hopped onto Lallu's back and Lallu started swimming home. Mac was excited. Say, Lallu, what's for lunch?
I don't know about you, but we are going to eat your heart,
said the crocodile. Mac laughed. Why didn't you tell me that first? I don't have my heart with me. I left it on the coconut tree. At that very moment, Lallu's wife swam up to them.
Where were you? I've been waiting for you for so long.
Lallu stammered.
My friend here is telling me he has left his heart on the coconut tree.
Oh yes, when we go out, we monkeys always leave our hearts on coconut trees. If you come with me, I will give you as many monkey hearts as you want, said Mac. So the crocodiles swam to the shore with the monkey riding on Lallu's back. The monkey hopped off Lallu's back and quickly climbed the coconut tree. Close your eyes and be ready. I will aim for your mouth. Lalu and his wife closed their eyes and opened their jaws wide. The monkey plucked a couple of coconuts and threw them down. The first coconut hit Lalu's wife, who yowled in pain. The second coconut landed on Lalu's head. The crocodiles quickly disappeared underwater. The coconut tree laughed. So, you leave your heart here, huh? He asked jokingly. I may leave my heart on a tree, but I carry my brain with me, said the monkey, laughing. The mango tree joined them in laughter. And that was the story of the crocodile and the monkey.